Welcome to the HSR, aka Honkai Star Rail Shader tutorial. So I'm going to discuss with you, Solarina, how the fuck to put a shader on Fujuan. And I want you to listen to every detail I have in this goddamn video. Okay, you ready? Okay. I will play Wave in the background so that you can understand and listen on to music. And it shouldn't be that loud. Okay? Okay. So, first, you want to go to Append. And remember the file I sent you? So, you would go to that same blend file. Do you see this material? Open that. You want to press this all the way down here. Leave this alone. Do not press that. Everything else, Genshin Body 1, Genshin Body 2, Genshin Body Alpha, Genshin Eyeshadow, MiHoYo Face, everything, okay? Append that. Now, for the next thing, you want to better FBX. You don't have to use better FBX at all, but you want to import her FBX file. I will be using better FBX so that the rig looks good. So we would go to her file, or any character's file, but I specifically have hers so that you understand how the hell to render her. Okay, okay. And it should work at any moment now. SCR, Dunks and Cunts, Fermi, Bleak. So now that we've got our model, now that we've got our hair mesh, now that we've got our files, our leaks premium, you know, we would go to this material mode. We would select every bit. So for the face, you want to go down to where it says Genshin face. This is what you do for the first material on the face. And that should select WAVK SCR body for me. Yes, I'm on you need. Write that WAVE. But you can't come with me. So for the eyeshadow, you would go down to where it says Genshin eyeshadow. Okay, press that shit. Press that shit. Okay. And it should work. Now for the hair, you would go to where it says Genshin hair. Do you see that? Press it. Okay, sorry, I had to hold on for a minute, Bleak. But, so pay attention to this. Notice how it says Fujuan Body 1. Press Genshin Body 1, okay? Genshin Body 1. Now go to where it says Fujuan Matte Body 2. Press that and select. Also, I want to turn this off so that you can actually hear me. Ah, no, hey, advertisements. Okay, so you would want to go to Genshin Body 2. Press that. So these two should both have Genshin Body 1. That's the first one. Genshin Body 2, which is the second one. Okay, now we are going to go down. And, you know, we are going to have it all the way here. So, do you see? I don't want to start on the hair, so I'll start on the first body material. So pay attention. You see what I have selected? Press that, okay? Have it, so that you can see what it has selected in the shaders stuff, okay? So, you see this? This is, by the way, you can edit the icons like this. I choose having it like this. So this is her first body material. This is her first body texture. Press it. Open image. And you want to make sure that it's marked as sRGB and channel packed. So you want to open that one for these two. The first two are just this one image, but SGRP and channel packed. Okay? Okay. Now for the next part, which is the light map. It's the same one of the body one, but it's the light map of that texture. So notice that we have the body one texture. This is basically the body one light map. It's what makes it look so pretty, basically. So you want to select on that and listen close for this. Mark it as non-color and channel packed. If it's not marked as non-color, you're not going to see any of the actual shading that comes from the light map. That's why the light map is there, so it can actually shade the thing. So you want to make sure you have those marked. And this is the same thing. This is the body one light map, and both are marked as non-color and channel packed. Now, do you see this? Do not set it to UV1. Mark it as UV0. Okay? Make sure it's marked as UV0 so that you actually know what the fuck you're doing. All right? Now, for this part, body shadow ramp. Notice how it's all the way connected to the warm ramp. And it's warm alpha. So for that one, you would go all the way to the warm ramp, Avatar Fujuan warm ramp. Not the hair warm ramp, but that one. Oh my gosh. I'm going to go back to that so that you can see. Okay? If it will just load at any minute. I just need it to load so you can see. Well, it doesn't say body, but Avatar Fujuan warm ramp. Not the one with hair in it. Not that one. Not the hair one. I just want to clarify that. But the warm ramp. Avatar Fujuan warm ramp. Okay? Okay. So you want to mark it as SGRB and channel packed for the warm ramp. You also want to go down to the second one. And do you see how it's connected to the cool? Like on these lines? You want to open that and also mark it to this, which is the Avatar Fujuan cool ramp. Not a hair. I just want to clarify that so you know. Not hair, but Avatar Fujuan cool ramp. So you'll just select that and just make sure that it is the file. Any minute? Okay. So you also want to mark it as SGRB and have it marked as channel packed. All right? Okay. If it will just load at any minute now. All right, we've got the first wave of this model done. Now on to the second part. MiHoYo Genshin Body 2. Now for this one, you want to do the same step as Body 1. You want to insert the diffuse mod, the diffuse textures. So that would basically be, for Body 2, it's this one. Body 2 color. Avatar Fujuan Body 2 color. That would be this one. It just takes time for my computer to load these. And we want to copy the same steps that we did for that onto Diffuse, of course. Just like we did in the Body 1 part segment. We want to do that for Body 2s. Same thing. Body 2, except we're going to the light map, and this is the Body 2, Avatar Fujuan Body 2 light map. So we want to select the light map. It will just load because my computer. And make sure, always make sure it's marked as non-color and that it is channel packed. So, yeah, we've got that. And now for the second part of the light map, which is the same thing, body to light map. And we've got it. So you don't have to worry about this again. It has already packed in everything, so you wouldn't have to edit it for anything. So since we already did that for the body one segment, we don't have to do it for body twos because it's already there. Make sure marked as UV0 for both of these. And it is. Now we want to move to the hair. And we're going to go to our folder, Avatar Fujuan hair color. Select that for diffuse. Basically the same thing as the body segment, you know? So we'll just do that for the hair part. Oh, oops. You can't really see that. But yeah, I did the same thing for this. Same thing for the fuse, SG, I mean sRGB channel packed, blah blah. Light map, non-color. And for the light map, of course, we want to do the same thing like we did with the body textures, except it's actually the hair light map. And remember, for the hair or for the light maps in general, always mark it as non-color, like we did for the body textures. Channel packed, light map, non-color. Again, hair light map, non-color, channel packed. And we want to set this as UV0, like we did with the body segment. The hair is basically just the same thing as the body part, but you know, just for the hair. Now we go over to the hair shadow ramps. These are the same as the body ramps, but just for the hair. And for this one, you would want to go to, which one is this? This is hair shadow ramp. Warm. So the first one is hair shadow ramp warm, sorry. But you would want to go to the hair shadow ramp warm, if I can even find that. Okay, this is the Avatar Fujuan hair warm ramp. We'll just wait for that to load. Okay. Channel packed. Again, it's sRGB, so it should be there. And again, for the bottom, you would mark this as cool as it's connecting to the cool ramp. So, Avatar Fujuan hair cool ramp. Open that. sRGB channel packed. And we have finished the segments for the body and the hair. Now, all we have to do is move on to the face. This isn't really a challenge. So remember, okay. Yeah. So we want to go to diffuse because we're on the genshin face part. We're on the face of our material. Or whatever you could say. So, all the way at the top, you're gonna see diffuse sRGB and channel packed. So you'll want to do the same thing like we've been doing. You'll want to get used to this for when you're actually putting the shader on these star rail models. And so we've imported the face to that section. Channel packed sRGB, you know. Now, face shadow, these models do not use face shadow, so you can just ignore this part. It doesn't really matter. It's just there. And for face expression, these characters do use face expression, and that is right over here. Girl face expression map looks like this. This. So you'll want to press it. It is marked as SGRB. I know you can't see it here, but it is marked as SGRB. And face light map. Face light map, you would put, sorry, my brain is sidetracking. You would put this, the face map, the girl face map, 1400 or whatever. You would put that in the face light map section. Now, I know that the names for these are confusing, but trust me, the face light map is... You would want to put the face map texture in the face light map section, as that is what is basically going to cause their, you know, lamp to actually work on their face. Notice how when I move the lamp, the shading on her face moves when I move the lamp, which is this. Like, notice when I press on this, the main light direction, her face will also move, and so will her body. So the shading on her face and her body will move. Sorry that my computer is laggy so that you can't really tell much. But notice within every frame that I'm doing this for, that the shading does actually move. The shading is actually present. You can see how it's actually moving on her face. Now, if you wanted to do this for the face, you could press on head driver, which is this little plane right here that you can see marked as head driver. It's this. But if you don't see this, just press on the plane, which is right here. And so you would want to move this. If you only want to change the shading on her face, all you have to do is press head driver and rotate it with R. And like so, the shading on her face, only her face, will change. The shading on her face will change. Now, for this face light direction, I actually forgot what that does. I don't think it's anything too important. I don't think it's anything too important, but basically, you have completed the test, or basically the tutorial that I put on this for you. If you actually understood what I put in the video, then I hope it helps when you're trying to put this shader on Honkai Star Rail models. Just know that the steps that we did, well, the steps that I did on Fujuan, this will work on any Honkai Star Rail model. Absolutely any. As long as you know that there's a body 1 material and a body 2 material, and that there is a hair material, and that there is a face, then all of those will work. I mean, then all of those will work. Jesus, I cannot speak. So I hope this helped you. I hope this assisted. And I'm going to make one for Honkai models. Thanks.